Ben OC here for Liverpool Live TV, and we're over in Oxton, which isn't actually Liverpool, but you know, it's close enough. And we're here with Diane Tremarco, who's launching her charity People in Need Merseyside. So Diane, can you just tell us a bit about why you've decided to set up this charity?
Okay, in brief, I was 2 years ago I was diagnosed with a disease called sarcoidosis, a very rare autoimmune disease, and I have the chronic form. And over a very, very long period, most of it spent in bed, hospitals galore, I just realised a couple of things. That one, there was a lot of people out there suffering, same as I have, and the isolation that I felt and the utter despair I felt, I just wanted to try and help somebody not feel that. So we sort of talked a lot in the last few months to family and friends and just thought, what can we do? And we decided that we would do it in a very small way, so no big licks, you know, we're not trying to be anybody. But if we can buy maybe an iPad or a Kindle for somebody who can then keep in touch with the outside world, the isolation wouldn't be as great. If we can pay some hospital fees, if we can pay a bill for them, you know, we don't know how much we're going to raise, but we hope that we can help some people, one person, and I'll be delighted.
Now, you might have just answered this question, but, you know, you could have easily just, you know, gave up and just stuck with it and done it by yourself and your family and just thought about yourself. So what is it in you that's made you think about other people? Why do you actually want to make a stand and make a change and change other people's lives?
Well, if it was just my family, I would probably still be lying down. I don't know. I believe there's healing in giving. That's one thing. But also, I went to some very dark places, which is not like me. I'm a very, very positive, upbeat person. And in view of the fact that these places were so dark, and I have got an extremely good network around me, I wondered about people who haven't got that network. I'm still recovering. I haven't got my medication right yet, so today is a rare day. I think I've been out sort of 10 days in the last 2 years, which is why I keep bumping into everything in this wheelchair, because I'm not used to it. yeah, absolutely. I've nearly killed a few people. But the idea is just to help somebody. I don't know why me, but I'm glad I did it, because, you know, it shows what lovely people we have around us. I think the world is 98% good, and that's why we're here today.
Now, on this leaflet, it says that, you know, one of the things that you want to do is cover hospital transportation costs. I mean, my question to that would be, why don't the NHS do that?
Unfortunately, the NHS they're desperate at the moment. They're in dire straits, as we all know. We see it on the television often enough. They can't do everything. They do a great job of trying to look after us. I have become frustrated with the NHS personally, because it seems a long time in between appointments. But you know, when you go in to do 5 or 6 tests every month, and you've got to park, and you've got to do this, and you've got to do that, then it adds up. And I say, people are not always blessed to have money. I personally couldn't get any benefits because I was self-employed. So that all the pennies start mattering, because you lose half your household income, you know, so. Yeah, so if we can help again in a small way, I'll be delighted.
And just to finish off, what would you ask people to do in order to support?
Well, you see, giving money has become a difficult thing to do. We're all in, you know, economic crisis. It's a hard world these days, and I wouldn't expect anybody to just reach into the pocket and give for nothing. I'd ask people who've been touched by autoimmune disease, who've been touched by people who are suffering. But also, I'd ask people who like to go out for a good night out, because we'd like to give them something in exchange for their money. Today, you've come to the launch, we have music, we have entertainment on, so we have some great raffle prizes, I'm sure you've seen them. There's a big night on October the 25th, it's actually my 50th birthday, but don't tell anybody. Yeah, no, thank you very much. You're only saying that. Yes, you are. Oh, you're lovely, I'm loving you so much, thanks. Could have been 30 something.
No, got to be worse.
Okay. I love it. So anyway, October 25th, the Flora Pavilion, all my great friends from the music industry have come together. We're putting on a huge show. I don't want any presents from my mates. I want them to buy a ticket to the show, £20, from the Floral website. And also,
if they can give you a present and buy a ticket, then that would be
awesome. Do you know what? I just want them to buy a ticket. Okay. and a raffle ticket maybe, because we're going to have some fantastic prizes. But also, one thing I would like to say is if people could jump onto the website, pinmerseyside.com. It's in its infancy at the moment, but it's going to become a real hub, hopefully, of information. And thank you guys so much for coming out. You've been an absolute, honestly, I'm really, really chuffed. Thank you.